A narcissist is a person who shows interest in only themselves and has predatory tendencies. They have difficulty enduring criticism or setbacks. They are commonly cynical, conceited, suspicious, selfish, scheming, and controlling of others. Narcissistic supply refers to the constant supply of attention and admiration needed by narcissists. To gain this attention, narcissists will often use a false self that is likable to attract people to them. However, because they are unable to make healthy connections, they tend to target people who are more vulnerable in order to feed their supply. The fact that they see you as a source of supply literally means they need you. They don't want you, but they need you. There are many tactics that they use in order to get their narcissistic supply. They may pretend to be an expert on something, manipulate others, turn on their fake charm, or violate boundaries. Narcissists need someone to supply their needs and someone to fill their empty void. So they will always be on the hunt, looking for someone new to offer them what they want. While some people are strong enough to laugh off their attempts to be manipulated into a supply and retain their strength, there are so many who are not that strong and fall prey to a narcissistic supply. With secure attachment, a person learns to trust others and love others for the rest of their life. But this is not true for a narcissist. Research suggests at some point in early childhood, the narcissist was not properly attached to or was insufficiently loved. Because of this, they learn how to survive in relationships by using others and not becoming attached to others because of the abandonment or not bonding that they experienced as a child. Narcissists do not know how to trust the goodness and authenticity of no one. Narcissists are all about protecting themselves at the expense of others. As a source of supply, the narcissist sees you as someone who can give them what they want and what they need. Here are some common forms of narcissistic supply. Number one, your time and attention. Number two, money, shelter, sex, food, transportation, and even your credit. Number three, compliments, praise, and gifts. Number four, control and power, being able to control you or having power over you. Number five, emotional energy, can be positive or negative. Negative would be getting a reaction out of you. Number six, an addictive substance or activity, such as drugs and alcohol, sex, gambling, and pornography. They obtain the supply from their victims with their primary tools, such as charm, seduction, manipulation, anger, and bullying. They are never satisfied once they receive the narcissistic supply. They soon become empty again. The narcissistic supply tank is always running low or on empty, as if there are holes in the tank. So no matter how much you try to love the narcissist, it will never be enough, which explains why they are not faithful to no one other than themselves. They depend on regular flow of narcissistic supply in order to sustain their superficiality. There are certain qualities that they look for in a victim, such as someone who is empathetic or someone who reacts quickly to their emotions, someone who is kind and compassionate, willing to put others first, modest, maybe attractive, intelligent, independent, willing to drop everything for them. A toxic person will sense when a person has poor boundaries, and they will take full advantage of them. Usually, they are able to weasel into many lives and leave these lives in complete chaos. What the narcissist really needs is authentic human connection, but since they perceive that as a serious threat to their psyche, they have learned to accept narcissistic supply as their source of sustenance. In order to cut their supply off, one way to do this is to go no contact. No contact involves removing the narcissist completely from your life. This strategy is proven to work as long as you commit to it. The other method would be the gray rock method. Since people with manipulative personalities feed on drama, the duller and more boring you seem, the more you undermine their efforts to manipulate and control you by using the gray rock method. So go no contact or utilize the gray rock method, which are two ways to cut the narcissistic supply. Gorgeous one. To get rid of a stray cat, you need to starve them. And this is the same analogy and method that you can use to cut off the narcissistic supply. Starve these troubled souls by not being their supply. I hope that this video was helpful and provided the insight that you are looking for.